Yesterday I cleaned the fish. They are my wish. They are not on the dish. I have something on my dish, but it is not fish. I love my fish. They are my wish. They are not on my dish, and they bring me real bliss. If you watch my fish, then you will feel the real love and bliss that they give me too. Shine on everybody to loving our pets, to loving each other, to rising above feelings, because they have so many meanings. Enjoy my fish, because they are my wish. They are not on the dish. They are my bliss, and they bring me real bliss. Love my fish, love all animals, love all creations. I will now share them all with you. There's someone on top of the fish. Hello, Destiny. You're beautiful. Hello, beautiful girl. Beautiful Destiny. Oh, beautiful girl. She sits on top with the owl. She moved it with the owl, and the owl, and Destiny, and the wolves, and Abraham, and Star, and Danielle, and Bob Marley, and my mum, and Danielle, and Star, and Destiny. Hello, Destiny. And Dylan. Ooh, he can smell food. Yum, yum. Enjoy the fish.
Right, drop this fellow. He's at the Marston Hotel.
Yes, sir.
Bring the melon too, would you? an hour ago, a woman named Diane Smith appears to have thrown herself off her own balcony. Appears to have. There's no reason to believe it wasn't suicide. And what makes it especially tragic is that Miss Smith was due to marry Philip Marston tomorrow morning.
This is his hotel.
One of them. Philip is an old friend of St. Marie. He employs about 100 islanders. So, I need to be reassured that this matter will be handled with speed, discretion, and dignity. Don't you worry, Commissioner. Discretion, tact, and dignity are my middle names. I mean, not really. Actually, it's after the little known symptoms, you don't need to know.
Looked out the home hotel for the wedding.
And all the guests were here in the terrace when Diane fell.
Yes, regrettably many of our guests, and several of my staff.
And you were out here yourself, keeping an eye on things.
No, I was heading towards my office. I actually passed Mr. Marston over there.
We'll need a list of who's staying in which room.
I'm afraid we don't usually release that information. It would violate our guest privacy.
I'm guessing you don't usually have guests chucking themselves off your balconies. Now, Diane's balcony.
That. 317 on the third floor. Anything else, I assure you my staff will be happy to help out. You'll excuse me.
Hold. So far, sir, the injuries are as expected.
Yeah.
That's intriguing.
Yeah, but only on the one phone. Having one nail a different color to the rest, or using your brows and makeshift pockets.
Not that I know of, sir.
It's a bit odd, don't you think?
You all right?
Yes.
And you keep on looking around. What is it?
Good policing, JP. Always alert.
There is something very fishy going on. I like that. Shine on. Who's eating my dinner? There is something very fishy going on.
Tell that man, because I've never seen him again, it'll be too soon. I did it. No. Been acting so weird since we got here.
No way, Sherlock, you worked it out.
But what's he got against you?
Let's just say we have history. Now let's get out of here. And fast.
You are safe. Despite all evidence to the contrary, you know that I am to call life.
So,
I'm just so I am clear. You have no concrete evidence to support this theory.
Not as yet, no.
Lieutenant Marston confirmed that the door was locked on the inside and I entered the room. It seems pretty clear to me. I think it's time to wrap it.
Trust me, Commissioner. I'd love to knock it on the head and get back to the shack and discover the joys in Alan Curry. But what if their answer was murder? To be honest, I don't know if I could live with that.
On your head, be it. Detective Inspector.
Commissioner, okay, we all done here? Nothing to report to you at the station.
Hold on, Dwayne.
Attention, Captain. This is now a murder investigation.
Murder? You sure about this?
Oh, yes. Diane Smith runs with our potential crime team. I need a full forensic sweep. There's a head maid, Audrey, I think her name is. She'll help me get set up in there.
Where you going?
You heard the man. Go and speak to Audrey.
Yeah, sure.
Well, I'm delegating.
We have 130 guests. Do we need to consider them all suspects?
Likely, whoever killed Diane wanted to stop this wedding at all costs. Even the most affected by her becoming a Marcy.
One of the immediate family?
Has to be.
Karen has been a terrible student. Stephen was in his room getting ready.
Yeah. What's
the thing you need? Karen was in a bathroom.
Dad.
Tyler, yes. What is it?
Are you going to be working all night?
What time is it? You must be starving. So sorry, look, the plan was I was going to try to do rescue Catholic. Melon curry. If you can believe that. Well, I have to use a melon to wrap the drug mule, and I don't think there might be evidence. So.
I'm not giving you a mask.
Why? Tell you what. Why don't we go out? So, what's on your mind?
When would you need to leave?
There's a flight from Guadeloupe the day after tomorrow.
Wow. I thought you were going to stay a couple of months. Where will you stay? You'll need money.
Well, Auntie Eileen says I can stay with her until I find a match.
Sounds like you've got it all worked out. Catherine, yes, whose brilliant daughter is about to take up her place at university.
You're leaving us? No. Well, I'll be back in the holidays. Your father's going to miss you.
You're joking. I've had enough of her cramping my style and getting on to my feet. Thought you'd never leave.
Hey, mm-hmm.
All right. Thanks, Eddie. Appreciate your time. Immoral, spineless, parasitic, bottom feeding.
That was a journalist.
Journalist. Polite a word for what he is, not a shred of remorse. He said the story came from an anonymous tip-off that landed on his desk. Someone is trying to discredit Diana, but why?
Maybe they wanted to drive her to suicide.
Or maybe they wanted to give her a motive to make it look like suicide.
Sir, are you alright? You seem a little
bit. You're sorry? No, I'm fine. I mean, Siobhan's leaving the island tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, absolutely. She's so beautiful. Wow. Yeah, really, really happy for her. Right, we're dealing with a family of billionaires. Let's not overlook the obvious. Dwayne, JP, see what you can glean about the personal finances of these five.
Yes, sir.
Right, what do we have so far? About Diane's
only child. Parents like you.
If we really believe it was a murder.
Oh, ye of little faith. Great, I'll tell you what. Prove me wrong. You'll never have to buy me a beer again.
You're on.
What about the children's mother? First, Mrs. Martin.
Died 15 years ago. Can't stand.
Karen is the oldest. She became managing director of the Marston Group when she was 20 years old. People now see as much as her company as her father's.
When I was 20, I was eating banana sandwiches and watching Carter.
Stephen is the company's global brand ambassador, which, as far as I can tell, means he travels the world staying as a guest in his hotels.
A little bit hard, Carl, the youngest.
Left school at 16, tried to get his mattress, with a few guitars and some other work.
In other words, she lives up a rich daddy. Toast.
Big toast. I'll check what you want.
Our rules, sir. There is a rule to Miss P. Plus. Carl Marston to do work experience in a group hotel.
Sounds like that he's putting his foot down.
And there's something else. I'm gonna try to check. And 5 weeks ago, Diane Smith called the police when a woman was banging on her door, shouting abuse.
Well, who was doing the charging?
Carl Marston. It doesn't take long with it.
Oh, sorry about that. But can you tell me, how did you feel about Diane becoming a stepmother?
She was never going to be that.
I thought you were arguing about the day you turned up on her doorstep.
That was nothing. She totes overreacted. It wasn't like I was a threat.
Well, sure. I was threatened. Why didn't you call the police?
It was only up to that. Diane never liked me.
I thought I was lazy just because I have a job or whatever.
So she thought you should go to work for the family firm?
I do work for the family.
I'm a monster. I'm preventing the band every time I go to the line.
What do you think I was going to do? Put on a uniform and serve people. Just couldn't let it go.
You know what I mean?
Toast.
Pearl, what do you think
led us to even die in to take her own life? Would you ask them?
What tipped her over the edge, isn't it?
Possibly an unfortunate choice of work.
Refusing to disclose anything.
Well, you don't get to be this rich without knowing how you're going to happen.
Who else would have access to this information?
Maybe their lawyers.
Yes, exactly. Sammy's lawyer was on the guest list for the wedding.
He's kicking his heels by the pool right now. You should go and talk to him.
Why me?
So I just noticed something vitally important. Look, Florence, Vasco da Gama.
What's that? Marco Polo. Morning of her death. Diane had a note in her diary. Chrissy wasn't who she was meeting, it was where? Christopher Columbus Street. So, my question to you, sir, is who booked the room for that time? Who was Diane meeting? I'm afraid there was no meeting.
You haven't even checked the system.
As general manager, I personally oversaw every last detail of this room. I know what was scheduled in every room in the hotel down to the last minute. And I can assure you there was no meeting in that room at that time.
I see. Well, we'll just have to take your word for it.
Do you believe him?
No, hold on a second.
And this suspense is killing me. You've got to tell me what happened between you and RG.
And which RG would this be?
You know, if I never see that man again, it'll be too soon, RG.
Oh, that RG. Ooh.
So, is she an old girlfriend?
Girlfriend is too strong a word, okay? We went out with each other for a couple of months around 10 years ago, that is all.
Why? That woman is angry. I mean, what did you do to her?
I don't know.
You don't?
No, seriously. I have no idea. I mean, listen, that if she ever saw me again, she would cut off part of me. I don't JP,
whenever women come to us,
don't ever ask them why they're angry.
It never ends well.
Ah, perfect timing. So,
after I had no luck
with the Martin accountants, I decided to run a check on all the currency exchanges on the island.
Well, thank you, Brent.
And I just received this.
$20,000, that's a lot of cash. Should I go over there and find out what you can? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, consistent with the fall, from a considerable head of control. No abrasions are
she's just lost her stepmother, for God's sake, and now you are making all kinds of insinuations.
Oh, Mr. Marston, isn't it absolutely sure we know the whole truth? Now, I believe Diane's and there's nothing left.
We know what happened. I was there. I saw it with my own two eyes.
You knew Diane, I knew. But what did I do? I struggle to believe that she would take her own life because of some rubbish written in the newspaper.
Oh, what a slot. Fair to you. Guilt and shame should be holding it.
Forgive me, now, the last thing I want to do is add to your suffering. I ever want to be your standard to
give. I'm a very wealthy man. But she couldn't tell us about the money. She loved me in spite of it, not because of it. And she
cared for me at all.
Name, attention, and kids.
No, what are the
money? She hung on in there, and they all came over in the end. I understood that, just as I did.
Of course.
Now, I know you
think it was not.
Own life, end of story. So you. Of the Marston class.
You've met my siblings, I'm the only brains.
But all the rest of them are you. Why the brains have trust upon you at the age of 22?
I'm kicking and screaming into the 21st century. When I started, we were still serving fish fingers and chips.
trusted her enough to take a key role in your business.
Yeah.
But not enough to let your father marry her without signing a prenup.
It wasn't personal.
Something special, you know? Send her back to London with a Caribbean glow. Oh, yeah. I thought I might make dinner at the shack. Got this great recipe for melon curry. Oh, sorry.
You're gonna miss her.
Funny old thing. I knew it was coming. I think I admitted to myself it'll be so soon.
I was the same with Camille. You spent all this time teaching them to be independent, and then wonder why they want to leave. Not us who cut the Akin strings. It's them.
You're right. Well, Siobhan's been independent since she was about 3 years old. Yeah, I'm the one who, well, I've never lived on my own before, put it that way.
Dad, your turn!
No. Limbo-related injury. Speaking of low bars, would you mind explaining why I spent much of last night talking to Matt and not promoting some officials on the weekend?
No,
Mr. Marston asked you to step back. You persisted in harangueing his children with baseless theories.
Harangue?
That's completely unfair.
You want to show me?
I can assume that Diane sees his voice. But we...
manager of the hotel and Stephen's old crew friend. I assure you.
Me and Duane are back at Jimmy Francois' house, and it's still all locked up. But we found a neighbor who knows her. She says that she lives here on her own. And, check this, she works at the Martin Hotel Academy.
Why would Stephen be visiting a hotel maid with $20,000? How
does it fit? Your friend here, Paul Jennifer, and I bet she give us every information that we need to know about Miss Francois if we ask nicely.
Oh, you do you? Mm. Yeah, well, that's perfect. You two see what you can get on Judy Francois.